Good morning, everyone. I'm Karen Ashford, and I have the distinct pleasure of being your MC for today's event. It's my honour to welcome you to this Flinders University graduation ceremony, an important occasion when we recognise and celebrate the efforts of the graduates here before us today. At the outset, I acknowledge that we are on the traditional lands of the Kaurna people of the Adelaide Plains. We respect their spiritual relationship with country and their custodianship of the Adelaide region, a rich cultural heritage that lives on in Kaurna people today. We extend our respect to the custodians of all the lands upon which Flinders reaches and teaches. Before we embark on the celebrations, there are a few housekeeping matters. There always are. We trust today's event will be seamless, but should you need to evacuate, please go to the signed exits. And should you need them, comfort facilities can be found in the foyer. Shortly, the academic procession will enter and the Australian National Anthem will be sung, followed by speeches. At the conclusion of the speeches, we will collect the graduates from their seats one row at a time to come to the stage to line up. Graduates, please follow the instructions of the staff to make your way onto the stage. As you get ready for your name to be called out, please note the tassel on your hat goes on your left-hand side. That's really important for good photographs. You will then cross the stage, greet the Chancellor and have your photo taken, and then continue across the stage and off the other side. Our staff will guide you back around the side of the room to your allocated seat. Our university's namesake, the great navigator, Captain Matthew Flinders, is remembered not just as an explorer, but as a man obsessed by the pursuit of knowledge. Together with Bungaree, a Kuringai man who acted as his interpreter and guide, Flinders was noted for his fearlessness and his determination that his actions would speak to the world. It is in that tradition that we, as a strong and distinctive university, continue to expand human knowledge and make a positive difference to society as an innovative and collaborative place to learn, research, and thrive.
Flinders University was founded in an era of profound social, political, and technological change. A product of these times, we have always been ready to step away from the security of the familiar and forge new ways forward. This appetite for exploration is ingrained in our DNA. It's shaped our world-class curriculum and the physical and online environments we live, learn, and work in, enabling new connections between academics, students, and industry. Brave research is the beating heart of our university, the purest expression of our desire to discover and our ability to solve. Ours is an inclusive culture that transcends borders and backgrounds. We believe absolutely in equality and opportunity for all. We work to serve our communities and empower our people, giving rise to healthier societies and empathic leaders. Our legacy, our values, our vision has never mattered more than it does right now. We don't just survive in challenging times, we thrive in them. We don't resist change or fear disruption, we embrace it, work with it. We adapt and evolve, we discover, we create, we share. We are Flinders, we are fearless.
I'd now like to invite you to please stand for the academic procession and to remain standing for the Australian National Anthem, sung today by Jess Bigg.
Thank you. We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty rich and rare. In history's page, let every state advance Australia fair. In joyful strains, then let us sing. Advance Australia fair.
Thank you, Jess. Please be seated. Chancellor Mr. Stephen Gerlach AM, Vice Chancellor Professor Colin Stirling, Deputy Vice Chancellor Students Professor Romy Lawson, Vice President and Executive Dean Professor Michael Gilding, Vice President and Executive Dean Professor Peter Monteith, Tanya Hosh, Clifford Coulthart, Associate Professor Anton Lucas, Uncle Mickey Kamacha Maracha O'Brien, Council Members Professor Christopher McKee and Douglas Gautier AM, members of university staff, graduates and guests. I would like to welcome Uncle Mickey Kamapi Maracha O'Brien, Kaurna Elder, to the microphone to deliver the Welcome to Country.
Nature, thank you for that, Karen. Namani. Oh, not many Kaurna speakers out there. So Namani is hello to you all, and Mani Ai is your response back. So Namani. Nature. Let's call upon the spirit people of the ancestors to bring us good blessings here this morning. Tuila Mani Budnik. Tuila Wakana Budnik. Nai Kaurna Biako, Makalankala, Madwachanga Kaurna Mina, Minyana Namani Puriji, Nai Nari Kamatbi Maracha, Nai Wangadi Mani Nabudni Gani Yatana, Yirindi Yata, Tanandanga, Karawira Pada, Turkandi, Flinders, Ku, Muka Arindi. So, welcome to the lands of the Kaurna people, and today we meet on the dreaming place of the big red kangaroo alongside the Red Gum Forest River, being the Torrens River. But today is a special day, a celebration of those who are graduating. It is wonderful to call upon the spirit people to bring good blessings to those who come here today, to send away the old or the sad that sometimes follows. But a welcome is saying that you are the important people when you come to a place, because you bring something with you, whether it be your knowledge, your wisdom, or just yourself. But it isn't just welcoming to a place, it's saying, do we know the place? Do we know the country that we share this country with you? And our people have always welcomed people to a place. They've been doing it for thousands of years. The one thing they've never done is said goodbye to anybody, largely because we have no word for that. But today I have a true story of myself, actually. It's a story when I went to the Great Wadi to become a law person. And then what he said to me at that time, he said he didn't want me to be a law person. He wanted me to be a person that lived and worked in the Western world so that I could support those who live in the cultural world. Because he said to become a lawman wasn't just a certificate, it was a lifelong thing. It could be a day, it could be a year, it could be many years. And the Western world system doesn't allow that. And so when we understand that today is a celebration of those who have learnt and gained much knowledge, it isn't just a certificate. It is something that we must contribute to give to others, to help those who can't necessarily become the educated. Because that's what life is about. It's about this yarra, this reciprocity, this giving and receiving, therefore becoming one. And so I wish the best for those who have graduated today, to use that knowledge and that wisdom, not just for themselves, for the others that to follow, but are needed for that wonderful knowledge and wisdom. So, Nachu Yukadaya, Nachu Yakandaya, Padnia Du Wadu, it's saying we are truly brothers and sisters and we walk together, do it in harmony, and like I said at the beginning, never say goodbye, always say nakata, being see you later. So, nakata ne chaya. Thank you. Thank you for coming today, and it's wonderful to see you all.
Thank you, Uncle Mickey, for that warmest of welcomes. Flinders University's Chancellor is Mr. Stephen Gerlach, AM, a law graduate from the University of Adelaide and an eminent South Australian company director. Mr. Gerlach has been Chancellor of Flinders University since 2010. He was awarded a Member of the Order of Australia for his service to the community. I invite Mr. Gerlach to open today's proceedings.
Good morning, Vice-Chancellor, Professor Colin Stirling, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, students, Professor Romy Lawson, Vice-President and Executive Dean of the College of Business, Government and Law, Professor Michael Gilding, Vice-President and Executive Dean of the College of Humanities, Arts and Social Sciences, Professor Peter Monteith, Tanya Hosh, Clifford Coulthard, Associate Professor Anton Lucas, Uncle Mickey, Kumapi Mariatja O'Brien, Council Members Professor Christopher Key, Mr. Douglas Gautier AM, members of university staff, graduates and guests. Before we begin, I would like to acknowledge that we are gathered today on the traditional lands of the Kaurna people, and we pay our respects to Kaurna elders past, present and emerging. On behalf of Flinders University, it is my great honour to welcome you to today's graduation ceremony event, celebration event for the College of Business, Government and Law and the College of Humanities, Arts and Social Sciences. To our graduates, today is all about celebrating you and your achievements. Graduation from university is a milestone achievement and a moment of great pride and joy. We have watched in awe and admiration as you have persevered through some of the most difficult years that many of us have ever faced. While we are here to applaud this achievement, I hope you take a moment for yourself to reflect upon and congratulate yourself for the hard work, determination and perseverance that has got you here today. You certainly deserve it. While today's ceremony is a chance for us to acknowledge your accomplishments, it is also an opportunity for us to consider the irreplaceable role each and every one of you plays in the legacy of Flinders University. When you venture into the world, you are further evidence of the fact that Flinders University has earned the reputation as the home of enterprising and brilliant graduates. You will join a community of thought leaders, game changers, innovators, and glass ceiling shatterers located around the world who are challenging the status quo and doing great things. The document you receive is not only a symbol of your academic achievement, but also of a personal one that should also be held in high esteem. It is evidence of your knowledge, skills, strength, and dedication, all of which will serve you well as you venture out into a constantly evolving world. I have little doubt that you will all go on to make your own mark, unique mark, on the world, not only through your actions and your contributions, but hopefully the kindness and empathy you show to others. I would also like to take a moment to acknowledge the loved ones and friends who have supported you throughout your journey to reach this milestone. They have been the ones who celebrated all of your wins and commiserated on your losses, and they have been the support you needed as you navigated the path of further study. For those of you here today who did not have such a valuable personal support network, or for those who have faced significant challenges throughout your studies, I would like to extend my sincere commendations. A university degree is by no means a walk in the park, and to complete one without a strong support network shows us that you have the tenacity and strength of character that will help you through all of life's challenges. While I am thanking those who have been a part of our graduates' journeys, I must not forget our talented and committed staff who have inspired and challenged you throughout your studies. Flinders University is incredibly lucky to be home to some of the world's leading teaching experts, whose fearless and dedicated approach to teaching underlines that Flinders University is never satisfied with settling. We are never complacent, and we are always striving to do better, to be better, and to achieve more. During today's ceremony, we are also celebrating the remarkable achievements of three individuals whose distinguished contributions to Flinders University and the wider community have improved the lives of others. Adia Matna Elder Clifford Coulthard is receiving a Doctorate of Letters in recognition of over four decades of tireless work that he has put in to record and conserve the cultural heritage of the Flinders Ranges. Social activist, leader, change maker, and visionary, Tanya Hosh is honoured with an award of Doctorate of the University for her long history of community leadership and advocacy that sets an example for generations to come. And we are also recognising long-standing Flinders staff member and passionate advocate for Indonesia-Australia engagement, Associate Professor Anton Lucas, who has been named a companion of the University of the University. Achievements and accomplishments come in many different shapes and sizes, but Mr. Coulthard, Ms. Hosh, and Associate Professor Lucas show us all how contributions, large and small, can help make our society a better place. Today marks the end of the first stage of your journey with Flinders and the start of a new stage as a member of a global community of more than 120,000 alumni who are shaping our future through integrity, courage, innovation, and excellence. You will join Fulbright Scholars, General Sir John Monash Scholars, Rhodes Scholars, South Australian and Australian of the Year, Logie's Hall of Fame members, healthcare heroes, literary icons, and sporting superstars, all of whom have called Flinders University home. You join the likes of law graduate Leanne Little, the 2022 Northern Territory Australian of the Year and Director of the Aboriginal Justice Unit, who has travelled thousands of kilometres to meet with and listen to First Nation communities across the Northern Territory. And for our graduates in Haas, you join the likes of Hannah Kent, internationally renowned novelist, and Peter Gers OAM, a veteran of local media, each making their own distinct mark locally and internationally. I encourage you to join our alumni network, which will help you stay in contact with the university and with each other. Just as we have been here throughout your education, we would be honoured to be invited to join you as you embark on your next chapter, to celebrate in your achievements, share in your lives, and be a part of whatever you do next. Goodbye and good luck to you all. We will be watching with interest as you each embark on your next fearless journey. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Gerlach, for overseeing today's proceedings and for your continuing contribution as Flinders Chancellor. I now introduce our Vice-Chancellor, Professor Colin Stirling, a distinguished and much awarded geneticist who has brought extensive experience in research and teaching to his leadership of Flinders University. Professor Stirling.
Flinders University is proud to present three honorary awards today, and our first is to Tanya Hosh for the award of Doctor of the University Honoris Causa. Tanya, please. Now, Tanya is a social activist, leader, change maker, and visionary. She was the South Australian recipient of the Australian of the Year for 2021. And when appointed as General Manager of Inclusion and Social Policy at the AFL in 2016, she was the first Indigenous person and second woman to be appointed to the AFL executive. In this role, she's transforming the AFL by advancing women, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, gender-diverse Australians, and the entire community. Tanya helped found advocacy organisation the Indigenous Players Alliance. She drove a new respect and responsibility policy, enabling women to seek redress for unacceptable behaviour, and a world-first gender diversity policy for a contact sport. She championed the first Indigenous Players statue of Nikki Winmar and instigated a review of anti-vilification policy. She helped secure an apology for Adam Goods from the AFL and delivered a new industry framework to help prevent racist treatment of players. In addition to her position at the AFL, Tanya holds board positions with the Australian Film, Television and Radio School, the Adelaide Fringe, as well as memberships, council and advisory positions with the Australian National University, BHP's Forum of Corporate Responsibility, Chief Executive Women, the Foundation for Alcohol and Research and Education, and NAB's Indigenous Advisory Group. Tanya has a long and distinguished history in Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander policy, advocacy, governance, and fundraising. In 2020, Tanya drove a hugely successful media campaign aimed at informing and protecting Indigenous communities from COVID-19. A career highlight for Tanya was contributing as a consultant on the 2019 ABC political drama Total Control, about an Indigenous female senator, and even snagged a cameo in season two. In 2017, Tanya was a member of the referendum council that led the process and final recommendation that resulted in the Uluru Statement from the Heart in May 2017. In 2013, Tanya was named in the South Australian Women's Honour Roll, the same year she and Jason Glanville addressed the National Press Club with Recognition, Why It's Right. She was recognised in the 100 Women of Influence Awards list run by Westpac and the AFR to recognise women who are achievers in Australian business and society in 2012, 2013 and 2015. And also in 2015, she was named in the Australian Women's Weekly Power list of Australia's 50 most powerful women. Tanya's been an Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander advocate at numerous organisations over the past 20 years, has held leadership roles in sport, the arts, culture, social justice, and public policy. Her work continues to shape policy and create space for diverse voices. Her leadership in the community sets an example for generations to come and facilitates real positive changes for Indigenous people and culture, benefiting all Australians. She's outstanding in her field and an extremely worthy recipient of an honorary doctorate from Flinders University. So, Chancellor, for the award of Doctor of the University, honoris causa, I present Tanya Hosh. Thank you and congratulations. And I now invite Tanya to address the graduates.
Wowzers. I feel deeply honoured to have this recognition. I know that I follow in the footsteps of so many people who've done much more impressive and difficult work than I've contributed to, who've received very little recognition. So to have an honour like this is a big deal, and I am deeply honoured. First, I'd like to start by acknowledging the Chancellor, Mr. Stephen Gerlach, AM, Vice-Chancellor, Professor Colin Stirling, Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Romy Lawson, Vice-President and Executive Deans, Professor Michael Gilding and Professor Peter Monteith, Uncle Mickey O'Brien, of course, for his wonderful welcome to Kaurna land, University Council members, university staff, the family and friends of graduates, and especially you, the graduates. Bit of a shout out to my friends and family who've travelled from across the country to share in this special moment with me today. An education is such a gift, and I'm so thrilled for all of you graduating today that you have had that privileged opportunity. Education is something that we should all have access to freely, but it's also a privilege to have that opportunity to study, to have that time to think about the work that you want to apply yourself to, the contributions that you will make. I never had such a plan for myself, but I had a strong sense of conviction from a very young age. And that conviction has been spurred on by my family, who supports me to do the work that I do, and also my dear friends, peers, colleagues, allies. I wouldn't be here without those people, and some of them are here today. My husband Andrew, my daughter Marley, my dear friend Doon, Katrina and Ruth. Can we give them a round of applause, because they're pretty awesome. One of the things that I've realised over time is that to make change, you do have to disrupt things. And it's better to do that with knowledge in your mind and to be informed, to be thinking and able to consider the perspectives and views of other people to help us get to a place that is better for everyone. I don't have very long to speak today, so I just want to leave you with a James Baldwin quote. It's a quote that I think about quite a lot, because when I first read this, I thought I could never articulate that any better. In the work that I do and am privileged to do, I often find myself confronted with some really challenging conversations. And I work in a world that is full of power and access and influence. And I often feel that I don't quite belong there. But what I do know after years of work is that there's a place for everybody, everywhere, no matter where you go. James Baldwin wrote that the most ferocious enemy of justice is power allied with ignorance. So all I would say today is ignorance does not have to be within anybody. We all have enormous access to information. Next year, the government, the federal government, has promised that we will have a referendum on changing the Australian Constitution to finally recognise the first Australians in our highest legal document. We don't currently exist in that document. Australia doesn't often change our constitution, and nor should we. But this is an exceptional cause. So my encouragement to you is to make sure that you're not ignorant going into the conversations that will be had across the country next year. And if you're indeed a supporter of ensuring that First Australians are recognised in the Australian Constitution so that we can have a voice into the Parliament, please vote yes. Make sure that you're informed. Spread that word, share that knowledge, and help bring this country together for a unified moment that will make us all better. Thank you.
Thank you, Tanya, for those inspiring words. Chancellor, I now invite Professor Michael Gilding, Vice President and Executive Dean of the College of Business, Government and Law, to present the graduates.
Chancellor, I present the graduates from the College of Business, Government and Law for the degree of Bachelor of Accounting, Yuqing Chen. Jinglong Deng. Tom May, also for the Bachelor of Business Management. Sean Place. Monpat Sayendi. Kei Zhu. For the degree of Bachelor of Accounting and Finance, Saima Ahmad. Christopher Birsch. Verity Robinson. Nisenga Everest Lusikia. For the degree of Bachelor of Accounting and Finance, Advanced Leadership, Olivia Donovan. For the degree of Bachelor of Banking and Finance, Cody Kevin Dennis Jones. Ema McDade. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, Sopari Sumrith. Victoria Joanne Soto, also for the Bachelor of Arts. T. Emily True. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, Advanced Leadership and Human Resource Management, Lisa Marie Mustaka. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, Advanced Leadership and Innovation and Enterprise, Jordan Bastian. Hayden Smith. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, Advanced Leadership and Marketing, Aaron James Daly. for the degree of Bachelor of Business Advanced Leadership, Jake Billich. Caitlin Chase, also for the Bachelor of Accounting and Finance Advanced Leadership. Renee Marie Profiris. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Human Resource Management, Lambro Costa, also for the Bachelor of Psychological Science. Tina Edelut. Francis Missouri. Thomas Joel Richardson. Dani Thomas, also for the Bachelor of Health Sciences. Brianna Elizabeth Watson, also for the Bachelor of Health Sciences. Connor Michael Williams, also for the Bachelor of Psychological Science. Samantha Wong. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Innovation and Enterprise, Alicia Duldig. For the degree of Bachelor of Business International Business, Sujin Chen. Luke Edwin John Crisp. Loris Diratani. Jake Dorshorst. For the Bachelor of Business Management, Cameron Anthony Brown. Hannah Grady. Grace Emily Joy Perry. Ashley Sullivan, also for the Bachelor of Sport, Health and Physical Activity. For the degree of Bachelor of Business Marketing, Anissa Abdullah, also for the Bachelor of Psychological Science. Lily Cavalier. Tong Choi. Sarah Jennifer Gershwitz. Scott William Hughes Lucas. Georgia Phoebe Pantelis. Christopher Emmanuel Paradisis. Angela Scarfo. Abby May Thomas. Finn van der Zaam, also for the Bachelor of Tourism and Events. Thomas Wilkinson. Rebecca Ziesch. For the degree of Bachelor of Criminology, Ali Bhattaji. Hope Blomberg, also for the Bachelor of Psychological Science. Yaslin Kaur. Emma Sophie Keys. Katrina Kontogonis. Ying Song Ling Lau, also for the Bachelor of Psychological Science. Tamika Valerie Rose McCulloch, also for the Bachelor of Psychological Science. Rachel Esther Roccasano. For the degree of Bachelor of Finance, Nate Hyder. For the degree of Bachelor of Finance and Business Economics, Vrinda Bhutani. For the degree of Bachelor of Finance and Business Economics, Advanced Leadership, Tristan Rex. For the degree of Bachelor of Government and Public Management, Garang Buol Deng. Catherine Roberts. Felicity Saddington. Simon Peter Schwert. For the degree of Bachelor of International Relations, Bianca Davis, also for the Bachelor of Languages. Macy Grace McKinley. Claire Malunga. Michelle Monaghan, also for the Bachelor of Arts. Sihopotso Ipiri, also for the Bachelor of Letters, French. Chloe Samuel, also for the Bachelor of Criminology. Angela Zeffi, also for the Bachelor of Languages. For the degree of Bachelor of International Relations and Political Science, Cormac Baird. Brianna Carter, also for the Bachelor of Business, International Business. Vahepona Semisi. For the degree of Bachelor of Law and Society, Michaela Torchett. For the degree of Bachelor of Laws, Gabriella Carr Foster. Caitlin Shea Fian. For the degree of Bachelor of Laws and Legal Practice, Joanne Ulchin. Jake William Chilman. Oriana DeAngelis. Amy Lynn Hawes, also for the Bachelor of International Relations. Lauren Hooper. Ria Jolly, also for the Bachelor of Business Human Resource Management. Patrick Lynch. Iwana Moliviatis. Yeah. Stephanie Sue Power. Stephen Rees, also for the Bachelor of Commerce. Angela Scarfo. Isabel Seagrim, also for the Bachelor of Accounting. Warwick Sterling, also for the Bachelor of Justice in Society. Yilin Tay, also for the Bachelor of Behavioural Science, Psychology. Millicent Page Veers, also for the Bachelor of Criminology. Karim Bassem Morgan. For the degree of Bachelor of Laws and Legal Practice with Distinction, Nadi Leilani Cox, also for the Bachelor of International Relations. Vanessa Irvine, also for the Bachelor of Business Marketing. Josephine Curie. Rebecca Jane Rayner, also for the Bachelor of Business, International Business. For the Bachelor of Laws with Distinction, Lucas Hannett. For an honours degree of the Bachelor of Business, Nihara Patirage. For an honours degree of the Bachelor of International Relations, Adam Turin. For an honours degree of the Bachelor of Laws and Legal Practice, Kaylee Feats. Helen Kremidiotis, also awarded a University Medal. Julia Vinci. For a graduate certificate in business administration, Kate Stanford. For a graduate diploma in business administration, Deborah Harding. For a degree of Master of Accounting, Tian Ching Hoa. Lam Tran. Rodolfo Velarde. For the degree of Master of Arts, International Relations, Sithi Hussain. Lauren Karubo Ogendi. Melanie Upashika Sembukuti Arakilage. For the degree of Master of Business Marketing, Peng Sheng. Chung Hung Lee. Siyu Wang. For the degree of Master of Business Administration, Jianhua Benjamin Chong. John Joseph Gervin. Hongxia Hu, also for the Master of Health Administration. David Raydell. For the degree of Master of Business Administration, Health, Tracy Christine Last. for the degree of Master of Business Administration Marketing, Xiaowei Shi. For the degree of Master of Health Administration, Philippa Jones. Christos Plakiotis. Gerald Wei Yeo. For the degree of Master of Laws, International Law and International Relations, Athenia Ardeen Moira Gilsonan Reed. Fazana Nazari. For the degree of Public Administration Policy, Vilinthone Saklotham. For the degree of Master of Public Policy, Novin Kelvianto Nurakba. Yuhan Wang. For the degree of Master of Public Policy and Management, Zaya Yawin. For the degree of Master of Public Sector Management, Arum Apriliana. For the Bachelor of Accounting, Martin Githiaka Mwangi. A doctorate demonstrates a significant achievement in both scholarly research and professional development. The next graduates to be presented have made original contributions to knowledge that benefit academia, industry, the environment, and our society. This research and these researchers will enable the transformation of knowledge. Graduates' thesis citations are printed in the graduation book. Chancellor, I now present the graduates for the Doctor of Philosophy. Gemma Kezia-Beal, by thesis entitled Recalibrated Expectations, a Qualitative Longitudinal Investigation into the Impact of High Rates of Precarious Employment on Workers' Employment Transitions Following the Closure of South Australia's Automotive Manufacturing Industry. I present Dr. Gemma Kezia-Beal. By thesis entitled Effectiveness of Evaluation Practices in Supporting Regional Development Planning in Indonesia, the Cases of D. Yogyakarta and West Sumatra Provinces, I present Dr. Dwi Raita Suryan Tining Esti. By thesis entitled The Purchasing Behaviour of People from Different Cultural Backgrounds in a Multicultural Nation, I present Dr. Felicia Kim. By thesis entitled The Contextual Relationship Between Earnings Management and Corporate Social Responsibility, Managerial Myopia versus Myopia Avoidance Perspectives, I present Dr. Salmeen Mustafa. By thesis entitled Indonesia's Foreign Policy and the Making of Regional International Society in Southeast Asia, I present Dr. Arianta Nugraha. I now invite Professor Stirling, Vice-Chancellor, to introduce our next honorary award.
Thank you. Chancellor. Flinders University is proud to present Clifford Coulthard for the award of Doctor of Letters Honoris Causa. For 40 years, Clifford Charles Coulthard, a well-respected Atnamatna man, an elder, has worked to record and conserve the cultural heritage of the Flinders Ranges. As a measure of his long-standing commitment, Cliff was one of the first three Aboriginal Heritage Rangers appointed to the South Australian Aboriginal and Historical Relics Unit in 1980, after working as a trainee for several years. From 1977 to 2018, Cliff has been consistent in his support for research teams in the Flinders Ranges, including researchers from Flinders University, archaeologists and rock art researchers. This involvement culminated in archaeological excavations at Wariatia Rock Shelter that have given us the earliest evidence of human occupation here in South Australia. This work was published in Nature in 2015 with Cliff as a co-author. Cliff has been committed to lifelong learning and has taken every opportunity to deepen his professional expertise, being awarded a study scholarship from Monash University in 1982 to study rock art in France. From 1991 to 1993, he used his own resources to spend time in the APY lands, extending his knowledge of Aboriginal traditions. Throughout his career, Cliff has endeavoured to be a bridge between Aboriginal and European worlds and cultures. He developed the first cultural awareness training packages for the South Australian Department of Education and followed this on his own initiative by taking parties of teachers and education staff on monthly study tours in the Flinders Ranges. He was featured in the magazine Australian Geographic and is one of six Indigenous Australians to be profiled in Six Australians, an ABC documentary featuring people who'd made efforts to reach out and share their culture and heritage. He continues this cross-cultural role in his position as senior cultural interpreter with Igawarta Homelands, an organization he formed in 1994 as a service to his Atnamatna community, and in his role as a board member of the Sharing Stories Foundation. Cliff Coulthard is a worthy recipient of a Doctor of Letters Honoris Causa, having shown a lifetime of commitment to Atnamatna scholarship, sustained interest in collaborating with and assisting a wide range of researchers, botanists, geologists, rock art researchers and archaeologists, a capacity to mentor early career Atnamatna students, and a pervasive interest in sharing his knowledge with others. So, Chancellor, for the award of Doctor of Letters Honoris Causa, I present Clifford Charles Coulthard AM. Thank you, and I now invite Clifford to address the graduates. Thank you.
Hello, South Australia. I'd like to first acknowledge the traditional owners, the Kaurna people, the Adelaide Plains, and I'd like also to, for my people in the Flinders Ranges, Atnamatna country. Atnamatna means rock people. And also, I'd like to also acknowledge or mention Lee Creek, because that's where I was born in 1953. And Nipabunna and Igawarra, but also my family in the northwest, the Yankandara. Yankandara and Pitjantjatjara people, mainly around Amata, Tupu, and of course, South Australia. And I'd like to also acknowledge the Monash University through in 1982. I had a bit to do with Trobe University, Adelaide, at Flinders University. I'd like to thank them for looking at me with my work through those 40 years. and also some of my people that I worked with. Bob Ellis was my director in the 70s in Aboriginal Historic Relics. Also, I'd like to acknowledge the Flinders University, and but people like Giles Ham, Peter Mitchell, that worked with me on the dig, and some of the Adnyamathanha people that worked with me from Nipabunna. And but also I'd like to say just Flinders University, and I'd like to say thank you, South Australia, and all the work that I did here with the people, and I could see that we are all working together today. Thank you, South Australia. Yeah.
Thank you, Clifford. Flinders University is proud to present Associate Professor Anton Lucas for the award of Companion of the University. Anton. Associate Professor Anton Lucas joined Flinders University in 1981. Already qualified with a Bachelor of Agricultural Economics from the University of New England in 1968, a Master of Asian Studies gained at the University of Hawaii in 1972, a PhD in Southeast Asian History from the Australian National University in 1981, and having just completed a one-year postdoctoral fellowship in the History Department at the University of Auckland. At Flinders, he was appointed to teach in the Indonesian language program established in 1978, and he became a key member of the team that established the Department of Asian Studies and Languages, and later the Asian Studies major. During his first decade at Flinders, Associate Professor Lucas not only taught in the Department of Asian Studies and Languages, but also trained postgraduates in the Social Sciences Research Training Center at Hasanuddin University, Makassar, South Sulawesi, and in the Inter-University Center at Gajah Mada University in Yogyakarta. From 1999, Associate Professor Lucas commenced involvement in three major Australian Research Council discovery grants, which examined land tenure, livelihood and the law, community, environmental, local governance and social capital, and the natural resource management in Indonesia. Associate Professor Lucas became head of department in 2002 and then director of the Flinders Asia Centre from 2004 to 2009. In addition, he taught in the offshore Masters of International Relations program in China, as well as co-supervising many Indonesian PhD students who studied at Flinders University. Associate Professor Lucas has worked tirelessly in his endeavours to improve Australia-Indonesia engagement and international understanding of Indonesian society. This included being a board member of the Indonesian Resources and Information Programme, which publishes the online magazine Inside Indonesia. He became a driving force behind community performance of Javanese gamelan music through participation in both the Oz Asia Festival and Indofest. Associate Professor Lucas and Mrs. Kadar Lucas gifted the Pendopo building and gamelan instruments to the university in 1990 to promote Indonesian studies and the performing arts. They've also made generous cash donations to support Indonesian language teaching and creating deeper links between Australia and Indonesia. In a letter of appreciation to Anton in his retirement in 2010, the then Indonesian ambassador wrote, and I quote, "Your persistence, advocacy, and kindness serves as a model for those who follow in your footsteps." Associate Professor Lucas is an extremely worthy recipient of the Companion of the University from Flinders University, as this publicly recognises his contributions to the university, South Australia, and the wider community to improving Australia-Indonesia engagement and a deeper understanding of Indonesian society. And so, Chancellor, for the award of Companion of the University, I present Anton Lucas. Thank you, and I now invite Associate Professor Anton Lucas to address the graduates. Anton.
The Chancellor, Mr. Stephen Gerlach, AM, the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Colin Stirling, distinguished members of the University Council and administration, and especially our new graduates. My congratulations to all of you who have graduated today, and a warm welcome to your proud parents and relatives who are able to be here, especially those from overseas. Many of you will be going back to your own countries and institutions. Some will be staying on to do a higher degree, gain work experience, or other qualifications here. As new graduates, many of you are facing the question, what am I going to do next? The answer to that question will be different for each of you. People of your generation are far more mobile and job flexible than people of my generation. Both of necessity, because of the way the job market works these days, but also because the acquisition of learned, transferable skills has been central to your education, in a way that it wasn't for people of my generation, and perhaps even of your parents' generation. This doesn't mean that you will end up turning your back on what you have learned here at Flinders. Apart from all the particular subject matter you have mastered to gain your degrees, your experience here has given you a solid foundation in the value of learning, a respect for the acquisition of knowledge in all its forms. And that is something that is sorely needed in today's world. The fundamentals that university education should give everyone, how to process knowledge gained from fieldwork, from library research or laboratory experiments, how to build hypotheses and write essays based on accurate sources and well-argued opinions, these skills are especially valuable in a world where alternative facts and opinions are put about as the truth. It was one such change of direction that brought me to Flinders, something I could never have imagined after I finished a four-year undergraduate degree in agricultural economics at the University of New England in Armidale. After graduating from there and with a scholarship to the East-West Centre at the University of Hawaii, there I met some ex-Peace Corps members fluent in Asian languages who pushed me into a master's degree in Asian Studies and Indonesian. This gave me a rich and rewarding career at Flinders in what became one of the leading Indonesian languages and studies departments in Australia, with its emphasis on putting language in a lived context, as a colleague has called it. This meant getting our students to Indonesia as quickly as possible as part of their study, which boosted their confidence and gave them the feeling of, wow, I can understand quite a bit of what people are saying. They seem to be understanding me. Putting Indonesian language and culture in context for our students also meant doing everything we could to bring Indonesia onto our campus at Flinders. One day, while I was having lunch by the lake with a colleague, we devised a plan to bring Indonesian language and culture out of the classroom and into a new building called a pendopo, or pavilion, where Javanese dances and gamelan performances by Australian students are held Indonesian visitors are made welcome and new dialogues occur. The misgivings of the then Dean of Social Sciences that the Pendobo would be nicknamed the Pizza Hut because of the odd shape of its roof, thankfully did not eventuate. Today, the Pendobo remains a living testament to a future that I never imagined for myself when I sat where you are now so many years ago. The principal of my high school told us in year 10, never distrust your moments of inspiration. They are the times when you are most truly yourselves. That was 60 years ago, but I've never forgotten it. And it's turned out to be the best advice my 15-year-old self could ever have received. I hope it will be true for your lives too, and that trusting your moments of inspiration and acting on them to the best of your ability will help you realize your full potential and be you and be who you most truly are. Thank you.
Thank you, Anton, for your generosity and ongoing contribution. Chancellor, I now invite Professor Peter Monteith, Vice President and Executive Dean of the College of Humanities, Arts and Social Sciences, to present to you the graduates.
Chancellor, I present the graduates from the College of Humanities, Arts and Social Sciences. For the Diploma in Creative Industries, Amy Roberts. For the Diploma of Arts, Wala Jaburi. For the degree of Bachelor of Accounting, Riley Ann Brooks. For the degree of Bachelor of Archaeology, Joanne Biggs. Trent Fogarty. Kate Lawrence. Amanda Ward. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Iftu Fahami Abdurrahman. Felix Fong. Catherine Gleason. Max Kowalik. Ainsley Louise McLeod. Courtney Riley. Robert Schliepek. Sir Samantha Willis, also for the Bachelor of Letters, Creative Writing. Degree of Bachelor of Creative Arts, Costume Design, Georgia Green. Degree of Bachelor of Creative Arts, Enterprise, Georgia Plowman. Degree of Bachelor of Creative Arts, Screen, Angus Beck-Smith. Tony Sayed, also for the Bachelor of Letters, French. For the degree of Bachelor of Creative Arts, Visual Arts, Benjamin Jeffrey Clark. Hannah Kate Emblem. Rosemary Joy Helmus. Holly Risedale. Chandra Wilton. For the degree of Bachelor of Creative Arts, Visual Effects and Entertainment Design, Vasiliki Argyropoulos. Hayden James Arthur. Sophie Arwich. Taylor Fullerton. Liana Gullich. Matilda Gunter. Lauren Hood. Monique Nguyen. Esther Annette Nielsen. Saxon Poser. Joshua Ruggiero. Claudia Smith, also for the Bachelor of Letters, Creative Writing. Tiana Tomlinson. For the degree of Bachelor of Creative Industries, Digital Media, Siwei Sun. For the degree of Bachelor of Media and Communication, Sarah DiOrio. Alana Marvell. Samuel Roberts. Eliza Monique Warren. For the degree of Bachelor of Media Arts, Jacob Anderson. Angus Andrew Evans. Cheryl Micah Watson. Also for the Bachelor of Letters, Creative Writing. Wanyu Shu. For the Honours Degree of Bachelor of Arts, John Matsis. Lise van Conklinburg. For the Honours Degree of Bachelor of Creative Arts, Joseph Bose Brulich. Aurora Serenity Sildatki, also for a university medal. For the Graduate Certificate in Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages, TESOL, Matthew Philip Canning. For the Graduate Diploma in Archaeology and Heritage Management, Michelle Kathleen Ellis Cronley. Fiorella Lucia Julka Munya. Elizabeth Claire Symes. Robert Christian Wheaton. Madeline Eve Sweck. For the Graduate Diploma in Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages, TESOL, Joyce Eva. For the degree of Master of Environmental Management, Satwinder Kaur. For the degree of Master of International Development, Kyuan Jantapulwong. Ishara Prasadini Gamhawagi. For the degree of Master of Language Studies, Ellen Margaret Avery. For the degree of Master of Maritime Archaeology, Amber Miles. Marcel Seaman Teschendorf. For the degree of Master of Screen and Media Production, Sifong Siobhan Low. Nan Wang, also for the Graduate Certificate in Biotechnology. Siddha Sher. For the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages, Tisol Kuldeep Singh. Wei Wei. Zhang Li Shu. For the degree of Master of Theological Studies, Mandy Jane Harvey. The next graduates are receiving their doctorate. Chancellor, I now present the graduates for the Doctor of Philosophy. Katerina Maria Bryant. By thesis entitled The Art of Falling and Searching for Loretta, I present Dr. Katerina Bryant. Belinda Joy Duke. By thesis entitled The Hidden Landscapes of the Cambodian Early Modern Period, circa 1400 to 1700, a landscape scale geophysical exploration, I present Dr. Belinda Joy Duke. Matthew Warren Firth. By thesis entitled English Kingship in the Saga Age, Memory Transmission and the Evolution of Narrative, I present Dr. Matthew Warren Firth. Jade Hastings. By thesis entitled Single Women and the Law, Crime and Legislative Change in Colonial South Australia, 1836 to 1880, I present Dr. Jade Hastings. Christina Mamone. By thesis entitled Transitional Justice for Long-Term Peace Building, a Case Study of Sierra Leone, I present Dr. Christina Mamone. Ryan David Manhire. By thesis entitled Cotutel, Unraveling Moral Certainty, Having a Rough Story, I present Dr. Ryan Manhire. Temetope Helen Olason Kanmi Alimi, by thesis entitled African Migrant Women Working in the Australian Aged Care Sector, I present Dr. Temetope Helen Olason Kanmi Alimi. Casey Rayside. By thesis entitled British Humanitarian Thought, The Morant Bay Massacre and the Bulgarian Atrocities, I present Dr. Casey Rayside. Shannon Sanford. My thesis entitled Drawing Digital, Exploring the Subjects and Spaces of Autobiographical Webcomics, I present Dr. Shannon Sanford. Ina Tripura. My thesis entitled Sexual and Gender-Based Violence and the Humanitarian Response, The Case of Rohingya Refugee Women in Bangladesh. I present Dr. Ina Tripura. Craig Westall. My thesis entitled Just Add Water, Transformations in a Peopled Riverscape in the Riverland Region of South Australia. I present Dr. Craig Westall. Flinders University offers its warmest congratulations and good wishes to all of our graduates, and I invite you to share your appreciation for their achievement by applauding their efforts. And I now ask Vice Chancellor Professor Colin Stirling to deliver the closing address.
Thank you. I'm delighted that we're all able to be here in person to congratulate our graduates after what has been another exceptional year. We've all had to manage the challenges and uncertainties of the COVID pandemic, and of course, to some extent, continue to do so. To our graduates, I especially congratulate you for your forbearance, your resilience and determination. You've successfully completed your course despite those tumultuous events going on all around us, and you should be justifiably proud of your achievements. To the families and friends of our graduates here today, I know this is also a very proud day for you as you witness an important step in the lives of your loved ones. Many of you will be here today as parents or perhaps grandparents, siblings, children, partners, friends. Whatever your relationship to our graduates, you'll have shared the ups and downs of their journey and have been there to support them and encourage them along the way. And so on behalf of the university, I'd also like to thank you for the support that you've provided and the sacrifices you've made that have helped our students become today's graduates. Now, graduates, I'm sure you've taken the opportunity to thank your guests personally, but I'd like to now offer you the chance to do so publicly. Would you please stand? Place those precious parchments on the chair behind you, turn to your guests, and offer them a heartfelt round of applause. Thank you. Please be seated. Now, I'm also joined on stage by some of our academic and professional staff who've taught and assisted you during your studies here at Flinders University. These staff represent a much larger group of teachers, mentors, and support professionals who've given you practical help and inspiration along the way. Our staff worked tirelessly to continue to deliver top quality educational courses despite the challenges of the pandemic, and that's ensured that classes and assessments and even professional placements were able to continue so that you have been able to finish on time. The creativity, commitment and continued effort of staff reflects our student-centered ethos, and I was delighted to see their efforts reflected in recent student experience surveys in which Flinders was ranked number 7 in the country for educational quality. Could you all please join me in showing your appreciation for these staff with a round of applause? Now, graduates, you've had a long educational journey with us, but of course your learning is never at an end. Learning is a lifelong endeavour. Throughout your degree, you've no doubt acquired many facts, processed a great deal of information, but information alone, of course, is not knowledge. Knowledge requires understanding, and it is this understanding that is the goal of education. So while facts and information literally inform the mind itself is also transformed by the very process of education. Or as Oliver Wendell Holmes once put it, a mind once stretched by a new idea never regains its original dimensions. Instead, you have the capacity to view the world in a new light, to see the facts not just as others see them, but to critically assess them in different and powerful ways. You've learned to become independent critical thinkers and can distinguish between the known and the unknown. And most importantly, of course, you've developed the skills required to ask the right questions in order to tackle new problems. Now, these are skills that you must now deploy throughout your life, analyzing the obstacles and challenges that you may face in the future and finding the solutions that will help you navigate them successfully. After this ceremony, you join a community of over 120,000 Flinders graduates living and working in 120 countries around the globe, and I encourage you to join our alumni association and to keep us informed of your progress and your developments, and also to keep in touch with the university and, of course, with one another. So please don't make today your last contact with the university. Keep us updated, and remember that our doors will always be open to you. So this isn't goodbye, as Uncle Mickey told us at the start of the ceremony. There is no word for goodbye in the Kaurna language. So, Nakada, we'll see you later. Good luck, good fortune. And on behalf of the university, I congratulate all of you graduating here today on your excellent academic achievement, and I wish you every success in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Vice-Chancellor, for those inspiring words. Graduates, as alumni, you have the power to change the world. But don't just take it from us.
I want to change careers. Well, if you need some mentoring, any kind of advice.
I get the opportunity to come back sometimes and talk to the students who are currently studying.
It is super inspiring to get those updates all the time from the alumni network.
It allowed me to say what could be possible looking forward.
I've sort of assisted with some of the outreach activities that have been conducted at Flinders, and I can see the richness that is provided by some of those courses.
I haven't gone this far if I haven't got the support from Flinders Alumni Network.
I've been kind of out of touch, and this is one way to keep in touch.
Flinders approached me about talking to current students just to perhaps give them some insight into what life might be like as a graduate. It's often given me time just to reflect on where I am and where I came from.
I think studying at Flinders really prepares you for the next stage of life, whatever you might choose. But I think we're all on a lifelong journey of discovery and learning. And I think what Flinders does well is teaches us how to learn and study. So whatever you take from you today will be useful moving forward in whatever direction you choose.
Congratulations to the graduating class.
You finished your education and now you're ready for the next step.
It's great to virtually see you here.
It's a time to really take chances.
So much hard work, and you've been through a very challenging time.
Celebrate your achievements, like you've got a university degree. It's crazy.
Congratulations to all those students graduating today. I graduated in 2004, and I never would have imagined that my studies would have opened the doors that it has for me.
Be fearless.
In concluding formalities, I invite you to stand for the academic procession as our dignitaries lead our newest graduates from the hall and onto their new path of achievement. ¶¶